Nature has given animals some body parts so that they can defend themselves, get food, and look cool. But sometimes those same body parts can hurt an animal so badly that it can easily lose its life. How exactly? Be sure to watch this episode till the end. We made it for you. Baru Babirusa is one of the most unusual creatures of our planet. It looks like a pig, but differs too much from its congeners. Piglet is small, its back is arched, its legs are long enough, and it has almost no fur. These animals prefer plant food and clean water. But the main thing about Babirusa is, of course, their fangs. In males, the lower and upper canines grow throughout their life and bend toward the head. It's not uncommon for a fang to grow so much that it begins to grow into the skull, literally. Imagine your tooth bending upward and going up to your forehead. It's not very pleasant, and it's dangerous too. And deer pigs don't like that either. In fact, I think fangs block the view. Fortunately, apart from their strange shape, their fangs are fragile. More often than not, though, they break before they reach the skull. For example, during a fight for a female, or just from time, if you're lucky, of course. Unlike deer pigs, things are much sadder for common reindeer. Their antlers are strong enough even to injure other animals. It's a real weapon that could very well cause the death of its wearer. Male deer fights are common. During the breeding season, they fight for females, and such battles often end in the death of one of their rivals. Most often, he just runs into another's antlers and... But during the fierce fight, the hapless males may also clutch the antlers so tightly that they can't deal with this situation by themselves. The end is very sad. The reindeer can't get up, can't eat, are deprived of the possibility to drink, and just slowly die. Nature can be ruthless. And if it takes place near the water, the reindeer can not only clash but fall through the ice together, then freeze, also together. But sometimes the animals are lucky and people notice their misery in time. It's enough to cut out a couple of antlers or shoot them off. Whoa, fella. I hope you knew what you were doing.
Unbelievable. Good shot.
What if you'd missed? Oh well, at least it ended okay. But while the reindeer can get trapped together by accident, things are much worse for Argali. These wild rams are considered the largest, can weigh over 100 pounds, and look quite menacing, especially if you look at their large, strong, corkscrew-shaped horns, which Argali use to protect themselves from predators and to fight for females. However, despite their majestic appearance, the fate of these wild rams is sometimes tragic. The horns, which are meant to be a powerful weapon of self-defense, can lead the animal to a slow and painful death. The older the Argali get, the more likely it is that their horns will begin to grow in the wrong direction and eventually pierce the ram's faces. Slowly and painfully, they will penetrate deeper and deeper until they result in death, either from infection or... Anyway, you get the idea. Evolution is a pretty ruthless thing. We should not thank it for such a trick with the poor ram's horns. However, human intervention, too, not always leads to something good. For centuries, people have been making more profitable breeds for agriculture. And it ended up, well, pretty controversial, especially when it comes to sheep. Wild species still lose most of their wool every year, so do some domestic sheep. But those that are bred for wool always regrow year-round without pause. And if you don't cut them in time, it can end very badly. Long wool is a bad option in very hot weather. Sometimes it leads to heat stress. There are also mobility issues. If a sheep with long wool lays down on a steep slope, it can't roll over from its back. It's like those bugs that lie with their legs up in the air. In addition, the wool causes vision problems. Not enough trouble? Excess wool, which isn't cut, begins to pile up right on the animal, forming knots. All sorts of parasites thrive under these knots. Insects cause unbearable itching, which disturbs sheep and makes them constantly rub against trees, fences, and against everything that it comes across. In such cases, the sheep may tear its sides until they bleed, which is a direct way to infection and sepsis. In extreme cases, the sheep with too many wool may die. So sheep need regular visits to the sheep barber. And here's another absurd fact for you. Donkeys need manicures. I'm not kidding. Like horses, most donkeys need their hooves cut at certain intervals. It's usually every 6 to 10 weeks. You got it right. Horses are subjected to this procedure as well. If the hooves aren't cut, the animal loses its ability to walk straight, which causes trauma, discomfort, and shock to everyone who sees the bent hooves, because it's a really creepy sight. I wonder how wild donkeys deal with that. And yet, there are so few wild donkeys left that I guess hooves would be the least of their problems. Being a hoofed animal is quite difficult because nature constantly strives to give you a death test. Even the most common places can become dangerous if the temperature drops a bit. Honestly, I don't know how deer end up on the ice and so far from the bank. An animal caught in such a situation is doomed if people don't come to help.
Yeah, let's get that other front leg. Yeah, you're good.
In this respect, nature is more favorable to us. We know how to keep our balance even on very slippery surfaces. Plus, we invented boats, ropes, hovercrafts, skates, and other useful things. You can use them to get any deer out of a trap. The only pity is that you won't get any thanks from the animals. Okay, if deer, rams, and other ungulates seem to be very unlucky in life, then there must be some species that got some bonuses from nature. Turtles, for example. They live long lives, don't rush anywhere, are well protected from predators by a tough shell, and must feel just fine. Yeah, I thought so too. Until I found out that turtles have one bug. They can't roll over if they're on their backs. Whoa, whoa, whoa. If you're about to comment about your pet turtle being great at this trick, let me clarify. We're talking about big turtles specifically. And it's not just a coincidence. The height, length, and even shape of a turtle's shell affects its ability to stand on its feet. For example, turtles with rounded shells roll over faster than flatter ones, and large individuals are much less nimble than smaller ones. The characteristics of the shell literally determine the animal's life. Accidentally flipped over on its back, a helpless turtle can be killed by the sun, starvation, or fall prey to predators. Turtles are especially vulnerable. Their rigid armor doesn't bend with body movements, which of course complicates the flipping process. Imagine a life that looks like a constant compromise between life and death. Larger individuals live better overall, but having reached too big a size, turtles risk one day falling into a fatal trap. For males, the issue of flipping is perhaps particularly important. In the process of fighting for females, they often fight and try to turn their rival over on their backs. But it would seem that large individuals clearly have an advantage. But once the big turtle loses, it'll never get up on its paws again. Sloths can hardly be called well-adapted creatures because, yes, they are that slow, exactly as you might imagine. Sloths spend most of their lives in the trees, barely moving and blending in with the foliage. Once a week, they come down to the ground to defecate. They sleep about 20 hours a day. Kind of reminds me of humans on vacation. But slowness and friendliness can cost sloths their lives, and the danger can come from anywhere. Any hungry predator can spot a slow animal and eat it. Why not? The dinner won't run away, even if it wants to. Even a spectacled owl, which in fact is not much larger than the sloth in size, can get the job done. It's just faster, stronger, and, well, it's hungry. We'll see you later.